Hello. We are still discussing test analysis, but now we'll focus on the activities. Let's get started. The activities under test analysis are analyzing the test basis. We have to analyze the requirement. And we have to evaluate the test basis. So we have to evaluate the requirement, which will tell us what is correct and what is going wrong. Let's look at analyzing first. The first document that comes under the microscope is requirement specifications. We have already covered why we analyze the requirement. It's because we are trying to find out what we have to test. We read the test basis, identify the testable features, then finally land on the test conditions. We have already covered this, so I'm not explaining it again. The second document that we analyze is the risk analysis reports. Each project will have its own risks. The product and project will both have risks. We have to analyze those risks, and depending upon those risk areas, we have to figure out what we need to test. This is why this document comes under test analysis. We have to analyze requirement and also the risk analysis reports to identify what we have to test. Now moving on to the second activity, evaluating the test basis. First, we have to check what has been omitted. What is there in the customer requirement but hasn't been noted in our requirement? Also, if there are inconsistencies in the requirements, we have to ask the customer for clarification. The same is true for inaccuracies in data sheet or input documents. We need to ask the customer to correct them. The second is contradiction in statements. Suppose the customer has given 100 lines of requirements, but some lines contradict each other. Maybe one line says, the window should move up in 10 milliseconds, while another one says, it should move up in 20 milliseconds. These are contradictory statements, and we need to get clarification from the customer. The third point is defining and prioritizing test conditions. What do we need to implement first, and what comes next? The final point is bidirectional traceability between test basis and test conditions. We have the requirement and that has to be mapped with our test conditions. This way, if the customer asks where is the test condition for this particular requirement, we can show them by using this traceability. This last point is very important, so you should note it down. In test analysis, we have to provide traceability between requirements and test conditions. And that's it for now. Until the next video, happy testing.